Hello my dear, how are you? I hope all of you will be fine. I am GD sir, subject teacher of English from LP Public School. Today we are discussing about the sentence. First we talking about the definition of the sentence. So let's see here, and if you have any problem then comment in the below comment box. So let's start the video. The sentence. What is the definition of the sentence? You see here, a sentence is a group of words. A sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. Which makes a complete sense is called sentence. For example, first you know about the sentence. Sentence is a group of words. Group of words that makes a complete sense. Complete sense. Okay? It is the definition of the sentence. A sentence is a group of words that make a complete sense. Okay? So, how can we identify, how can we know about that it is the group of words and it is the express the complete sense? So, let's start the example. Like he goes to school. It is the small example of the sentence. So you can see here, he goes to school. He is a word, goes is a word, to is a word, and school is a word. Okay, there is a many word used in this sentence. So it is the group of words. It is the group of word. One thing is clear, it is the group of word. And in the second sentence, you will say that it is the complete sense. So he goes to school. It is the express sense. What he do? What he do? He goes to school. Okay? How can you say it is the group of word and it has a complete express complete sense? Then I will give you a second example. Like school to go. He. Okay? So you can see here, school is a word, to is a word, go is a word, and he is also a word. It is group of word. It is also a group of word, but it has not a complete sense. It is not expressed the sense. Okay? So we cannot say that it is the sentence. But this statement is express the complete sense and it has also a group of word. So we can say that it is the sentence. Okay, it's clear. Next is part of the sentence. Part of the sentence and kind of the sentence is different. I will tell you the kind of the sentence in the next video. Okay, first you know about that part of the sentence. Part of the sentence. This sentence divided into two parts. Okay, this sentence divided into two parts: subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. Like, what is the mean of the subject? Okay, what is the mean of the subject? We can say that the subject of the sentence is the part which denotes the person or things we are talking about. Okay, it is the denote the person or thing we are talking about. For example, Ramesh writes a letter. You see as the sentence, and in this sentence, one person is right something. Who is right? Ramesh is right. Okay? Ramesh is right. So this Ramesh word is the subject of the sentence. Okay? Ramesh word is the subject of the sentence. Why? Because these words denote a person. Denote a person. It is not him, but it is denotes a person. Okay? And we are talking about this person. Like who writes a letter?
Ramesh writes a letter.
So it is the this part is the subject part. Okay, this part is the subject part. Clear? And what is the mean of the predicate?
What do you mean by the predicate?
So predicate means the predicate is that part of the sentence which tell us about the subject. Okay, it is the part of the sentence. This is the part of the sentence that tells us about the subject. It means this part will be predicate. This part will be predicate. Why? Because all these verbs done by the subject and this part tell us about the subject. It means what does the subject do? Okay. So this part will be predicate. Here in the subject part, you will remember that in the subject part always you will find the any noun words like any person name, place name, animal's name, etc. or the word used in a subject. Okay, and in the predicate, the work that done by the subject, and word will be predicate. It means leave the subject, select the subject, and after the selection of the subject, rest of the part in a sentence, rest of the part will be predicate. It is the easily identify of the sentence. Clear? So you will know about the subject and predicate and how can we define it. What is the meaning or definition of subject and what is the definition of the predicate? Clear? Now we are talking about the attribute. Okay. So attribute means the adjective or the adjective phrase that qualifying the subject word. That qualifying the subject word in a sentence. In a sentence is called attribute. Okay. I gave you an example like it. The hot weather caused the death of many birds. The hot weather caused the death of many birds. Okay, first you divide this sentence into two parts. This is the subject part and rest of the part will be predicate. Clear? In this part, weather is the main noun word, is the noun word, and here the hot word is the adjective and the is the article word. Okay, but these both words is qualifying of the noun word. It is the noun word and these words are qualifying noun word, and so this word means the hot word will be the attribute. Clear? It is the phase, adjective word or adjective phase. If the adjective word or adjective phase qualifying of the noun word in a sentence, then it will be attribute. Clear? So here the main subject or noun word is the weather, and the hot word also qualifying of the weather word. So this the hot word will be attribute. Clear? Next is adverbial qualification. What do you mean by the adverbial qualification? The an adverb or an adverb phrase that qualifying the verb. Okay, qualifying the verb. Okay, is called adverbial qualification.
clear? It means an adverb. Adverb means, you know about that adverb. Adverb is the qualifying word of verb. An adverb or an adverb phrase that qualifies the verb in it is called the adverbial qualification. For example, example is, we ran all the way, or where we ran all the way, we ran all the way. Okay, first you can see that we is the subject. Ran is a ran all the way is a predicate word. Okay, but ran is a verb. Ran word is a verb in a sentence. And after the ran, you can see all the way. All the way is the word that qualifies of the verb. That qualifies of the verb. So these are. So these all the way word will be adverbial qualification. Okay, these word will be adverbial qualification. Clear? Where a adverb or adverb phrase, adverb or adverb phrase, this is adverb or adverb phrase that qualifies of the verb. Has the verb run? Ran. Ran word is adverb and these words qualify of the ran word, so these word will be adverbial qualification. Clear? Next is object. Next is object. First we will talk about the definition of the object. The person or thing that receives the action or of the verb is called object. Okay? It means where in a sentence when we receive the action of the verb. Action of the verb, then it will be object. Like Sarita is reading a book. Sarita is reading a book. You can see that here the Sarita is the noun word and is reading is the main or helping verb and rest word will be object. Okay, it is the noun word. It is the noun word and this word. What was the Sarita doing? Sarita is reading. Sarita is reading. And what is he reading? He reading a book. This noun. This verb. This verb word also received by the object. It means a book. Clear? So this book word will be object. Clear? And we can also say that finitive or non-finitive. Okay? Transitive and intransitive. You also heard about that. Transitive and intransitive. So this verb will be transitive verb. Why? Because it has a object. Clear? And this object also divided into two parts. Direct object and indirect object. Direct object and indirect object. How can we identify of the direct object and indirect object? Where? You will see like if I will change this sentence in a different way. Like Sarita is making tea for her guest. Or Sarita gave a beautiful book to his mother. Sarita is Sarita gave a beautiful pen
You see here the things, and when in a sentence you will find the things, anything, then it will be direct object. And you can see here, Sarita gave a beautiful paint. Paint is a direct object. It is the direct object, and her mother, it is the indirect object. So you will see that here is both are the object used in the sentence, like direct object and indirect object both. It is the direct object. If the non-living things used in a sentence as an object, then it will be direct object. And when we use living things as an object in a sentence, then it will be indirect object. Okay, I hope everyone understands this topic very well. And if you have any confusion, then you will comment in the comment box, and I will try to next video to understand, try to teach you about the kind of the sentence. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this video very goodbye for watching this. Hello my dear, how are you? I hope all of you will be fine. I am GD sir, subject teacher of English from LP Public School. Today we are discussing about the sentence. First we talking about the definition of the sentence. So let's see here, and if you have any problem, then comment in the below comment box. So let's start the video. The sentence. What is the definition of the sentence? You can see here, a sentence is a group of words. A sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. Which makes a complete sense is called sentence. For example, first you know about the sentence. Sentence is a group of words. Group of words that makes a complete sense. Complete sentence. Okay? It is the definition of the sentence. A sentence is a group of words that make a complete sense. Okay? So how can we identify, how can we know about that it is the group of words and it is the express the complete sense? So let's start the example. Like he goes to school. It is the small example of the sentence. So you can see here, he goes to school. He is a word, goes is a word, to is a word, and school is a word. Okay, there is a many word used in this sentence. So it is the group of words. It is the group of words. One thing is clear, it is the group of words. And in the second sentence, you will see in the second you will say that it is the complete sentence. So he goes to school. It is the express sense. What he do? What he do? He goes to school. Okay? How can you say it is the group of word and it has a complete express complete sense? Then I will give you a second example. Like school to go he. Okay? So you can see here, school is a word, to is a word, go is a word, and he is also a word. It is group of words. It is also a group of words, but it has not a complete sense. It is not express the sense. Okay? So we cannot say that it is the sentence. But this statement is express the complete sense, and it has also a group of word. So we can say that it is the sentence. Okay, it's clear. Next is part of the sentence. Part of the sentence and kind of the sentence is different. I will tell you the kind of the sentence in the next video. Okay, first you know about that part of the sentence. Part of the sentence. This
sentence divided into two parts. Okay, this sentence divided into two parts, subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. Like, what is the mean of the subject? Okay, what is the mean of the subject? We can say that the subject of the sentence is the part which denotes the person or things we are talking about. Okay, it is the denote the person or thing we are talking about. For example, Ramesh writes a letter. You see as the sentence, and in this sentence one person is write something. Who is right? Ramesh is right. Okay, Ramesh is right. So this Ramesh word is the subject of the sentence. Okay, Ramesh word is the subject of the sentence. Why? Because these words denote a person, or thing. It is not thing, but it is denotes a person. Okay, and we are talking about this person. Like, who writes a letter? Ramesh writes a letter. So it is the this part is the subject part. Okay, this part is the subject part. Clear? And what is the mean of the predicate? What do you mean by the predicate? So predicate means, the predicate is that part of the sentence which tell us about the subject. Okay, it is the part of the sentence. This is the part of the sentence that tells us about the subject. It means this part will be predicate. This part will be predicate. Why? Because all these works done by the subject, and this part tell us about the subject. Means what does the subject do? Okay. So this part will be predicate. Here, in the subject part, you will remember that in the subject part, always you will find the any noun words like any person name, place name, animal's name, etc. or the word used in a subject. Okay, and in the predicate, the work that done by the subject and word will be predicate. It means leave the subject, select the subject, and after the selection of the subject, rest of the part in a sentence, rest of the part will be predicate. It is the easily identified of the sentence. Clear? So you will know about the subject and predicate, and how can we define it? What is the meaning or definition of subject, and what is the definition of the predicate? Clear? Now we are talking about the attribute. Okay, so attribute means the adjective or the adjective phrase that qualifying the subject word in a sentence is called attribute. Okay, I gave you an example like the heart wither caused the death of many birds. The heart wither caused the death of many birds. Okay, first you divide this
sentence into two part. This is the subject part and rest of the part will be predicate. Clear? In this part, vida is the main noun word, is the noun word, and here is the hot. Hot word is the adjective and the is the article. Okay? But these both words is qualifying of the noun word. It is the noun word, and these words are qualifying noun word. And so this word means the hot word will be the attribute. Clear? It is the phase, adjective word or adjective phase. If the adjective word or adjective phase qualifying of the noun word in a sentence, then it will be attribute. Clear? So here the main subject or noun word is the verb, and the hot word also qualifying of the verb word. So this the hot word will be attribute. Clear? Next is adverbial qualification. Adverbial qualification. What do you mean by the adverbial qualification? The adverb or an adverb phrase that qualifying the verb. Okay, qualifying the verb. Okay, is called adverbial qualification. Clear? It means an adverb. Adverb means, you know about that adverb. Adverb is the qualifying word of verb. An adverb or an adverb phrase that qualifies the verb in a is called the adverbial qualification. For example, is we ran all the way. Or we ran all the way. Okay, first you can see that we is the subject, ran all the way is a predicate word. Okay, but ran is a verb. Ran word is a verb in a sentence. And after the ran, you can see all the way is the word that qualifying of the verb. So these are the way word will be adverbial qualification. Okay? These word will be adverbial qualification. Clear? Where a adverb or adverb phrase, this is adverb or adverb phrase that qualifying of the verb. Here's the verb run, ran. Ran word is adverb, and these words qualifying of the ran word. So these word will be adverbial qualification. Clear? Next is object. First we will talk about the definition of the object. The person or thing that receive the action or of the verb is called object. Okay? It means where in a sentence when we receive the action of the verb, then it will be object. Like Sarita is reading a book. Sarita is reading a book. You can see that here the Sarita is the noun word and is reading is the main or helping verb, and rest word will be object. Okay, it is the noun word, and this word, what was the Sarita doing? Sarita is reading, and what is he reading? He reading a book. This verb
this verb word also received by the object, it means a book. Clear? So this book word will be object. Clear? And we can also say that finitive or non-finitive. Okay? Transitive and intransitive. You also heard about that, transitive and intransitive. So this verb will be transitive verb. Why? Because it has a object. Clear? And this object also divided into two parts: direct object and indirect object. Direct object and indirect object. How can we identify of the direct object and indirect object? Where? You can see like I will change this sentence in a different way. Like Sarita is making tea for her guest, or Sarita gave a beautiful book to his mother. Sarita is Sarita gave a beautiful pen to her mother. Okay, here is the things. You see, here is the things, and when in a sentence you will find the things, anything, then it will be direct object. And you can see here, Sarita gave a beautiful pen. Pen is a direct object. It is the direct object, and her mother, it is the indirect object. So you will see that here is both are the object used in the sentence, like direct object and indirect object both. It is the direct object. If the non-living things used in a sentence as an object, then it will be direct object. And when we use living things as an object in a sentence, then it will be indirect object. Okay, I hope everyone understands this topic very well. And if you have any confusion, then you will comment in the comment box, and I will try to next video to understand, try to teach you about the kind of the sentence. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you like this video. Goodbye for watching this.